I just feel like people enjoy seeing really cool people flying through the air, you know, kicking their bike around, flipping, spinning, like all that stuff is just exciting to watch. So I think, you know, we're going to captivate an audience that maybe didn't know that they love BMX freestyle, but I think after the Olympics, they're going to fall in love with it. My pathway to coaching was a pretty interesting one because I was coaching the women initially because I was also an athlete trying to gain Olympic spot personally for the USA. And when they, you know, we had a couple competitions and my results just didn't stack up to what I hoped they would. So at that point, I kind of had a choice. Well, you know, I could try for 2024 or, you know, the USA needed a coach for the men's side as well. Since I've really dived into being the head coach of the Team USA BMX freestyle team, it's like, you know, I'm finding such enjoyment in helping these other riders get to where they want to be to reach their goals. Our sport of BMX freestyle is a little bit different. Like, we don't have like kind of prerequisite tricks or even like a standardized score for certain tricks. Our event is kind of based on, they call it like overall impressions. Obviously tricks that have never been done before in a competition score really high. And then also just the more difficult ones, you know, like if you're able to use the entire course really creatively in a way that a lot of people wouldn't actually see or typically do, that counts for a lot as well. So it's called freestyle for a reason, because it's just like you get 60 seconds, and similar to like an artist, it's your palette. You know, like you can create on that, paint on that canvas whichever way you want, and then you show the artist your artwork and you're like, do you like it? And then they go, we really like it, we're gonna give you a 99. That's what you hope for, you know. One of the things I love about our sport the most is the life lessons it teaches. So, you know, for us, we fall down, we're protected, we have all the equipment on, helmets and everything, but we get back up, you know, and that's one of the most important life lessons I've learned through BMX freestyle is being able to fall down and then dust yourself back up and then have the confidence to go out there and correct those mistakes and then keep marching and improve yourself as a rider, as a person, everything. Hannah Roberts is an amazing competitor, amazing bike rider, amazing human being, actually. She's just got the best heart. She's super polite, super just well-mannered. But on the bike, she is a total beast. I mean, she is just a force. And it's an amazing thing to be able to coach an athlete like that, because she is self-motivated. You know, she's very good at setting these goals for herself. And the great thing for her, which is really exciting, is, you know, usually when she learns a trick, it's pretty much the first time any woman has ever done that trick on a bicycle. So that in itself is just exciting to be a part of too. I think Great Britain, for both the men and women, have a really great program. A lot of talent coming out of there. Them on the women's side, there's a rider, Nikita Dukeros, and she's a rider for Switzerland, another amazing talent. On the men's side, you know, you have a lot of veterans. You have Daniel Dares from Venezuela, but I know that Japan has a really talented rider as well, Rim Nakamura. He's incredible. You know, I think if I was to name a few, that's a pretty good list, you know, but, you know, there's going to be 9 men and 9 women out there that are all just going to be, you know, out there because they're amazing, you know, because they qualified and they rode, you know, the best. And so it's going to be a good show. It's going to be very, very exciting.